secret of mine is so you don't want it to boil over effect, you put a little olive oil in there. Gotta have it al dente. I hate watery spaghetti. And I hate watery sauce too. So I like to read the paper and wait, you know, while you're waiting for the spaghetti to boil. This is always an art trying to try it because it's hot, so you gotta bounce around your hand a bit, you know. We're not ready yet. Now this sort of stuff drives my mom crazy. Instead of bringing the pot over here, I'll just do this. So, you know, I don't care if it drips, you know what I mean? Who cares? This is always an art trying not to spill this stuff. This is all done within 20 minutes. Gotta have cheese. Definitely gotta have cheese. You try to set it up here like this so you can eat, you can read the sports page. You try this. Good, real good. Try some.
The drive to two consecutive Stanley Cups has been anchored by a championship defense. And this year, the play behind the blue line was the best in Penguin history. Paul Stanton, Grant Jennings, and Jimmy Pack gave the defense youth and speed. 6'6" Shel Samuelson provided a steady stay-at-home presence. Larry Murphy soared to his finest season ever. A Norris Trophy finalist, the smooth-skating Murphy gave the Pens a strong offensive thrust from their own end, pouring in a career-high 85 points. While Murphy gave the defense a quiet class, Ulf Samuelson was the Penguins' Terminator.
I really don't hold back much at all. I just go right for the body. A lot of people don't appreciate that.
Some guys you can intimidate and they might back off, but you just, you know, laugh and smile at you, and that may make you even more irritated. Alfie's bad to the bone.
Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone.
I know he's tough, but no, he's different on the ice. Like anybody else, it's like if you do a job, you're different, and then you're home, you're different. You know, you just don't go together. If he has a bad game, he leaves there at the rink, and if it's a good game, you know, it's great, but you know, he's not gonna bring it home.
At home, hockey's toughest Swede turns into an eager playmate for his 2-year-old son, Philip.
All right, standing, everything.
Go to bed.
Go to bed.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I like to spend some time around the house with our son Philip and our dog Oliver, and just kind of hang out and rest between games. He really likes watching hockey. Whenever I'm sitting down in the penalty box there and get a close up on me, he knows it's daddy.
Ulf Samuelson was not the only Penguin to dish out big checks. Ow! Jay Caulfield, Troy Loney, Dave Tippett, and Mike Stapleton, along with rookies Mike Needham and Jeff Daniels, were the team's unsung heroes. They worked outside the glare of the spotlight, shadowing opposing players while producing some big goals of their own.
Trying to close the play down, Tippett comes in, he fires! Shoots and scores! Dave Tippett almost ended up in the net. Tippett shorthanded to Stapleton. Hey! Shoots and scores! Mike Stapleton gets the Penguins' first shorthanded goal.
When defensive forward Mike Stapleton isn't playing hockey, you can find him at home, chilling to his own music.
I remember every Christmas I'd tell my mom, I want a guitar out of the Sears catalog. I'd get the Sears catalog and they'd not open up to the page and say, Mom, I want this guitar right here. The first many I ever made, I went right in and bought my, you know, guitar that I wanted. So I think I appreciated it more.
Yes, I needed a little time away.
While Stapleton relaxes by making his own music, rookie Sean McEachern simply picks out a CD.
Like Bob Marley.
I like the top 40 stuff. I like all different stuff. I like the Eagles. I like Bobby Brown, Mark Cohen, a lot of different people. Billy Joel.
Jimmy Pack made me buy this. Garth Brooks, I'm not too much into country though.
Somehow the glamour of the NHL has passed by this quiet Boston native.
Well, sometimes I'll, you know, replay what happened in the game. Maybe I missed a chance to score, or maybe I get a goal. I'll think about that. And usually I'll go get something to eat and then come home and watch some TV for a while. I like to watch David Letterman. Talk to my girlfriend on the phone before I go to bed, and that's about it.
On the ice, McEachern's blistering speed spoke volumes, propelling this rookie to the top of his class.
McEachern into the way, goes in, he shoots and scores! He scores!
Fellow rookie Martin Straka added even more quickness to the lineup. By the season's midway point, the Penguins had run away from the rest of the Patrick Division. The race was only half over, and already the Pens saw no one in their rearview mirror. Mario was scoring at a record pace. With 104 first-half points, he had one arm wrapped around the scoring crown, while the other reached for the NHL record books. It was one fun-filled ride after another. It all seemed too good to be true.
It was absolute shock.
As you all know, Mario Lemieux was diagnosed with Hodgkin's disease. It has been recommended that he undergo 4 weeks of radiation treatment.
I was scared for him and scared, you know, what's next and what lies ahead.
Just the word cancer scares you a lot. And, you know, that was probably the worst day of my life. I didn't cry right at the time that I was with the doctors, but I got in my car and actually started crying the whole way down to my house. And, you know, that was probably the toughest day of my life.
For a team that has seen more than its share of tragedy, the news that Mario Lemieux had Hodgkin's disease was a crushing blow.
We're a team that hardly can lose a game, and all of a sudden we have the word cancer involved, and you know, people lose lives for that.
I was amazed when the doctor sat in my office and told me that what they had found, and then the more we learned about it, the more we heard about it, the more we understood about the disease, things were a little easier to swallow.
Despite the shock, the prognosis was good. Mario was undergoing major doses of radiation and was expected to be gone for 8 weeks.
It was like a kick to the stomach when you read the press release and saw that it was Hodgkin's disease, and I think the city was in mourning for a few days.
Well, I believe we were all sick. Every fan here and everybody in the city of Pittsburgh and around, they were all sick.
I just sat there and cried. I was devastated. You know, he's been through so much. You know, what more can he overcome?
Mario's first public appearance came at the NHL All-Star Game, where players and fans alike saluted the league's brightest star with a standing ovation. He watched as his all-star teammates, Tockett, Stevens, and Jagr, all scored in a lopsided victory.
Tockett fires it by him. Recchi across the line for Stevens. He scores. And Jagr scoring a 14th goal.
For the sensational Jaromir Jagr, life in the NHL has been unbelievable.
Lemieux gets the puck, throwing in front. Here, Jagr with a chance. He turns. He shoots and scores. Jaromir Jagr wins it in overtime.
You're unbelievable.
Jaromir Jagr, NHL All-Star, radio weatherman, and teenage heartthrob. When fans found out that he loved Kit Kat candy bars, they sent them to him by the truckload.
Some people sent me some Kit Kat. I had over 1,000 Kit Kat home. I eat it all.